Now, let's discuss how to find the central mass of a hollow hemisphere. Similar to the previous cases, if we are having a hollow hemisphere of mass m and it is of radius r, we can state that its central mass will be located somewhere on the y-axis, which is the vertical line passing through the center of this hemisphere. And we also consider its horizontal diameter as x-axis for our calculation purpose. Again, in this situation, to find out the y coordinate of the center of mass, we need to consider an element. So here, we consider an elemental strip ring of mass dm. Obviously, in the situation of a hollow hemispherical part or any hollow spherical section, we have studied that we consider element in polar form, like from vertical direction at an angle theta, we consider a small angular width d theta, and we consider an elemental strip ring like this, which is having a width r d theta. This is actually a ring which is on the surface of this hollow hemisphere. We are taking it because the whole mass is distributed on the surface of this hemisphere uniformly. So, width is of width r d theta. Here we can find out the radius of this ring. If this is r, the radius small r can be written as capital R sin theta. Here this is the radius of this elemental ring. So, we are required to find the mass of this elemental ring, which can be easily calculated by multiplying mass per unit area on the surface with the area occupied by this elemental ring. So, the total mass of this hemisphere is m and the surface area of the hemisphere is 2 pi r square. So, in this situation, the elemental mass can be written as m upon 2 pi r square, which is the mass per unit area multiplied by the area occupied by the element. For this element, the circumference of the ring will be 2 pi r sin theta and the width of the strip is r d theta. So, it is 2 pi r sin theta into r d theta. So, here this is the total mass of this element, which can be simplified as 2 pi r square will get cancelled out. Here dm will be m sin theta d theta, this is the mass of the element. Now, in this situation, if we just see the y coordinate of this elemental mass dm, here dm we are taking as mass of this elemental strip. If we just find out the y coordinate of this dm, it can be written as this radius of this hemisphere is r. So, this will be r cos theta. So, we can write the y coordinate of center of mass, which can be given by the expression 1 by m integration of dmy. This was the expression we have used for finding the y coordinate of center of mass. So, in this situation, if we substitute the values, dm can be written as m sin theta d theta multiplied by, we talk about its height, the y coordinate of this dm can be written as r cos theta. Here, as we are integrating it in terms of theta, the limits of theta can be substituted for the complete surface of this hollow hemisphere. It can be given from 0 to pi by 2 because theta is changing from theta equals to 0 from top to the bottom of this hemisphere, that is pi by 2. In this situation, this m gets cancelled out. This will give us, we can take this r common. To simplify the sin theta cos theta, we multiply and divide this expression by 2. So, we can take this r by 2 common. It is integration from 0 to pi by 2. And 2 sin theta cos theta can be written as sin 2 theta d theta. We can very easily integrate the expression as r by 2. Sin 2 theta will be integrated as minus cos 2 theta by 2. And integration limits we substitute from 0 to pi by 2. If we just substitute the values, this will give us r by 2. First, we put theta equals to pi, this cos pi. Cos pi can be written as minus 1, so this will be 1, so it is 1 by 2. Minus of lower limit, if we put 0, it is 1 by 2, so it is plus 1 by 2. The result can be written as r by 2, which is a very useful result. Similar to the case of half ring and half disc, this is also going to be used in many cases. So, keep in mind, in case of a hollow hemispherical section or for a hollow hemispherical cup, which is of radius r, the center of mass is located exactly its middle height. So, yc can be written as r by 2. This is also a useful result. We'll use in several problems now.